We all have encountered mix and match offers in our daily life. Those are offers where you can buy different but related products to the same per unit price. Sometimes this means you can make a great deal. You get something which is usually more expensive for a cheaper price. Usually, though, it means you're making a very bad deal. I feel the mix and matching that is occurring in the EU between the fundamental right to privacy and the fundamental right to the protection of personal data is the second sort of a deal. It's a Brexit deal. It's not good for us, actually. In my short 6 minutes and a bit, I want to therefore point out why we should make a difference between these two fundamental and human rights, and especially in the European Union, where there are actually two different fundamental rights in the Charter. For this purpose, I will first roughly outline a working definition of both, and then give some reasons why to make the distinction. So what is the fundamental right to privacy? If you're familiar with privacy scholarship, you know that this question is actually a bit of a riddle to answer. There's no definite answer to it yet, and I will also not try to answer it tonight. I will just try to give some rough outline, which I get from the court cases and from the law, what it could mean. So privacy first is your freedom, is the freedom that gives you the right to live your life according to your own choices within certain limits of the law. This is also called decisional privacy. This very rough concept becomes more concrete if you think about the cases that have been adjudicated under this right in the different courts around the world. These cases include, for example, gay marriage, the recognition of transgender rights, birth control options, abortion, but also your right to be a nudist in some cases. All those issues have been adjudicated under privacy, and all those issues are clearly not about data protection. There is one aspect, though, about data protection that is closely related, about privacy that's closely related to data protection. That is the aspect of protection of private information. You should have control over who can reach and who is the audience of your private information to make a fence between your private life and your public life. What is then the fundamental and human right to data protection? I would say it's about two things. First of all, it's about some kind of management rights over your personal data. I say management and not control on purpose. Secondly, what data protection does, it gives us the security that all around us, our personal data is processed according to certain rules and principles. These are set by international standards, these are set by the law, and also they are supervised by an independent supervisory authority. If you now look at both of them together, you see a first obvious difference. This is the scope. Personal data does not have to be linked to your private life at all. It can be true public information, and it would still receive, at least in the European Union, their protection. While private information always has to have the strong link to your privacy and potentially also needs to harm you if it gets out. In this context, it is very important to note that the fundamental right to the protection of personal data in the EU is not the GDPR. The GDPR tries to implement the fundamental right, but it also has other objectives. So now to the reasons why you should separate them. The first reason is that they have different goals and hence they need different tools to implement them. For example, you have a car insurance that tracks your actual driving, and based on this you have to pay either more if you drive good according to this tracking mechanism. You pay more if you drive bad according to the tracking mechanism, or you pay less because you drive good. This would infect your decisional privacy because your freedom to drive however you want to within the limits of the law would be severely restricted. Then think about a health insurance that would give you a fitness tracker, and then according to the steps you take, you would either pay more for your health insurance or less. Again, this would severely limit your freedom to make your choices, your decisional privacy. You cannot live the unhealthy life you want to live because you're forced by insurance to be better. I think all those are severe interferences with our human or fundamental right to privacy, and like this, they have to be measured as an interference to a fundamental right, according to the rules in the Charter. If you now look at these insurances from the perspective of data protection, you realize that data protection cannot stop these interferences in our freedom to choose. But data protection offers us transparency. I think the right of data protection in insurance cases would offer us the right to know, okay, if I cross now a red light, I have to pay 200 euros next year. Or if I only do 100 steps today, I will pay 50 cents more next year. This is the transparency data protection should provide us. That they are different, you can also see in the Cambridge Analytica case. That they try to influence your political choice is a problem of decisional privacy. That they handle your data intransparently is a problem of data protection. Both address different issues and have different tools. A second reason to separate data protection and privacy is to get this concept of control out of data protection, because control over your personal data in an online environment is not possible. Even if it's granted by a company, they will design how it's granted, so it's still not absolute control. Instead, control is something, in my opinion, that should belong in the realm of privacy. You should be able to control your private information. You should be able to stop it from getting out if it could harm you. This, I think, is currently lacking in our laws, because data subject rights are always limited in their scope. They cannot give you this position of power over your private information. The second reason why control should be separated from data protection is that it puts us in charge of supervising the law. We are the compliance officers, and I think it's a fundamental right, so it's the state's task to overlook this. They should give more money to data protection authorities. It should be they policing our personal data. I hope I could make clear why to separate data protection and privacy. I think it's necessary to address the underlying issues appropriately, and if to come back to the mix and match offer, it's necessary to see what each of them are worth to us.